In today's class, we are going to discuss the next topic, that is introduction to three-dimensional geometry. This is class 11th, chapter number 12 in your NCERT textbooks. The textbook you have this topic. So my dear students, first of all, we will see what is the weightage for this topic. So total weightage for this topic is 2 plus 5 marks, 2 mark one question and 5 mark one question. So total 7 marks weightage for this topic. So what is the topic name? Introduction to three-dimensional geometry. My dear students, this is entirely new topic for you. Before whatever studied, some concepts we studied in the earlier classes like 10th, 9th we studied. But introduction to 3D means three-dimensional is a entirely new concept for you. So please, here visualization is very, very important. So please concentrate, and imagination is also very, very important. Clear? So please give the concentration more so that you can easily understand. So my dear students, before that, we discussed in the earlier classes, first of all, any two lines, say here it is, if I have the any two lines, this is x dash, this is x axis, and this is, we can take it as y axis. If the two straight lines intersect at a point O, then if two lines intersect perpendicular to each other, then the plane here, this xy plane, this where this plane, this we can call it as xy plane or coordinate system we can call. So this, if two lines intersect each other at a, here it is, perpendicular to each other, then we have four parts that we discussed in the earlier classes. So here it is. So this is, we can call it as first quadrant. So this we can call it as first quadrant. And this we can call it as second quadrant, and this we can call it as third quadrant. Clear? So please remember, if we have the two lines perpendicular to each other intersecting at a point origin, if these two lines are perpendicular to each other, then we have four parts. These parts we can call it as quadrants. So this we can call it as first quadrant, this we can call it as second quadrant, this we can call it as third quadrant, and this we can call it as fourth quadrant. Clear? And my dear students, also we know that this is positive, this is entirely, this is a x-axis. So from origin to this side, this we can call it as a positive x-axis, and this we can call it as a negative x-axis. Therefore I wrote x dash. Likewise, this is y-axis, so this is positive y-axis and this is negative y-axis. So therefore I wrote it as y dash. Clear? In the first quadrant, my dear students, please observe, in the first quadrant, x always we will write, please remember, always we will write the any point x comma y. So in the first quadrant, we have positive, x-axis is positive and y-axis is positive. So therefore, in the first quadrant, the signs will be positive, positive. And in the second quadrant, my dear students, in the second quadrant, x dash, it means x is negative and y is positive. So therefore, in the second quadrant, the sign will be minus plus. Likewise, in the third quadrant, this is negative x-axis minus, even y is also negative. So therefore, negative, negative. This is in the third quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, my dear students, positive x-axis and this is negative y-axis. So therefore, plus, minus, we can write. So like this, we are dividing the xy, here it is plane, into four parts. Clear? My dear students, please remember, this is all we are using to denote or to locate any point. Say, for example, if I told you to locate the point 1, 2, so if I wanted to locate the point 1, 2, means, my dear students, where it comes here, or else 1, 1, take care of this. So 1, 1, if I wanted to locate this point 1, 1 in the xy plane or in the coordinate system, means what you will see, x here it is, x value is 1, here it is, and y value is 1. So here it is, the point will be, here it is, 1, 1. Like this we will denote. So 1, 1, if I wanted to locate on the xy plane, means what it indicates, my dear students? It indicates that the point 1, 1 is a point x distance, here it is, from here to here it is 1 unit distance. From the y-axis it is 1 unit distance, and here it is, this point indicates that y place, always this is first in the ordered pair, first element indicates the x and the second element indicates the y. So if I wanted to locate the point 1, 1 in the coordinate system, means what it indicates, that I am explaining here it is. So 1, 1 means what? The 1, 1 means 1 unit distance from the y-axis and 1 unit distance from the x-axis. Clear? So this is the meaning of the point 1, 1. It means, my dear students, we are going to use this coordinate system to locate the any given point that indicates. If I write, for example, if I take 1, 1 means what? 1, 1 means this is a point which is located 1 unit distance from the y-axis and 1 unit distance from the x-axis. So this is the notation to we can use to locate the any given point. Likewise, my dear students, you can take 2, 2, -3, 2, whatever point they given to you, you can locate like this. So this is all about xy plane. My dear students, whatever I explained here, it is, these all we learned in the earlier classes. So here it is. Actually, our concept is three-dimensional. So whatever I am discussing here is, this is two-dimensional. Please remember, my dear students, this board you can take, or your plane, that is book you can take, these are all two-dimensional. Why it is two-dimensional? Two-dimensional because we have x-axis and y-axis. Only two axes we have, so that the example for the two-dimensional geometry, 2D is the board as well as your book. These are all two-dimensional. Here it is, two-dimensional we can call, my dear students, or xy plane we can call, or we can call coordinate system. So this is, we can imagine, we can see, my dear students, whatever we have, 1, 1 or 2, 2, whatever we have, this is, we can draw on the board or on the paper, we can draw and we can easily see this one. But three-dimensional means, here we are considering three axes. What are those? X-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So we are studying in three-dimensional space, three axes we are taking. So what about three axes, or why should we study? That I am going to explain. So I think you understood all these concepts. So this we learned in the earlier classes. There is no any new thing here to explain. Just concentrate here. This is a concept we learned. Just I recalled here this. Actual concept is three-dimensional geometry. So first of all, I'll explain why should we study three-dimensional geometry. What is the use of it? So please remember, my dear students, if you wanted to calculate, if I wanted to calculate, or if I wanted to denote a point, suppose consider here is a one point in a space, if we have one point. So where is the point? To locate that point, we required three-dimensional geometry is required. And another one case is, if you wanted to locate, or if you wanted to calculate the position of the fan, consider a ceiling fan. Clear? So ceiling fan, the tip of that fan, if I wanted to calculate, means the position of that point, to calculate that, we required again three-dimensional geometry. Clear? Or else, if I wanted to calculate the position of the bulb, if you consider any one bulb, CFL bulb you can take, or any bulb you can take, my dear students. So if you wanted to calculate the tip of the bulb, to that case we required three-dimensional geometry. Clear? So now, how we use three-dimensional geometry means, say for example, my dear students, consider one point is here. I already told you that the imagination is very, very important. So consider one point here. This assume here one point is there. If I wanted to calculate the location of this point, the position of this point, if I wanted to calculate, means what should we require, my dear students? So we required the distance from the, here it is, bottom, that is bottom to this point, here it is the distance that we calculate, we should require. And also we required the adjacent to adjacent side walls distance also we required. It means if we required three distances so that we can say where will be the point. So please remember, we required, here it is, if I wanted to calculate any point in the space, the position if I wanted to calculate, means here, say for example, consider one point is there. So if, or else consider like this one pen or whatever you can calculate. Here, if I wanted to calculate the position of this tip of this pen, means what should I require, my dear students? I required three axes. What is that one? One distance is the distance from the bottom, from this point to the bottom. And also I required the distance from this, here it is, let us say I am in a teaching in a classroom, so the distance from this point to this wall, and also I required the distance from this wall to this point. If I know these three distances, then we can easily say the position of the tip of this pen. So therefore we should study the three dimensional geometry, my dear students. Clear. So more in higher studies you are going to use the applications of 3D. You may heard the three dimensional 3D. You may go to the cinema hall and there they will give you one spec and they'll tell you that 3D movie, I went for the 3D movie, like that you may heard. So what it indicates, so in that also we are using this three dimensional geometry. And even nowadays you can use, you can see the 3D pictures also, you can, I mean 3D walls, 3D paintings you are watching, these are all 3D meditations. There we are using more than two dimensional, it means three dimensional is required. So therefore that we can, for that reason we should study this topic. So this is just introduction, means how to calculate the distance between two points in the space, that all we are discussing in this topic. Am I clear? So this is just introduction. Actually brief the introduction is there in the class 11th. In the class 12th, in more detail we are going to study. Clear? So please see my dear students. So ellavarigu navu en madidvi anta helidre, just I explained 1-2 minutes in briefly in Kannada. So my dear students, navu yake 3 dimensional na calculate madbeku, yake study madbeku 3 dimensional geometry anta helidre. So ಇಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ನಾವು ಕಲಿತದೇನು ಟೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿ. ಟೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ಎರಡೇ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್, ಈಗ 1,1 ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ 1,1 ನಾನೊಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಅಥವಾ ಎರಡು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಗಳ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಅವಾಗ ನಾವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ? ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಎರಡು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಎರಡು ಎಕ್ಸಿಸನ್ನು ಮಾತ್ರ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ. ಸೊ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತಿತ್ತು? ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೋದಾಗಿತ್ತು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲೈತಿ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು. ಬಟ್ ನಮಗೇನಾದರೂ ಸಪೋಸ್ ನನಗೆ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾನ್ದ ಟಿಪ್ಪನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟಿಪ್ಪನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಬಲ್ಬ್ದ ಟಿಪ್ಪನ್ನು ನನಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಅದ್ರ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಬಲ್ಬ್ದು ಟಿಪ್ಪು, ಅಥವಾ ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಪೆನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಪೆನ್ ಒಂದು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ರ ಟಿಪ್ದು ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲೈತಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನನಗೆ ಬರೀ ಎರಡು ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನಫ್, ಎರಡು ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ನನಗೆ ಇನಫ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ದಿಸ್ ಪೆನ್, ಈ ಪೆನ್ ಇದು ಟಿಪ್ಪನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಬರೀ ಟೂ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವೇನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ? ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್, ತ್ರೀ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಯಾಕೆ ತ್ರೀ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಪೊಸಿಷನನ್ನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಪೆನ್ ಇದು ಪೊಸಿಷನನ್ನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನನಗೆ ಮೂರು ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬೇಕು. ಯಾವುದ್ಯಾವುದು? ಒಂದು ಬಾಟಮ್ದಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಸೈಡ್ ವಾಲ್ದಿಂದ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಈ ಸೈಡ್ ವಾಲ್ನಿಂದ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸು. ಈ ಮೂರೂ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾದಾಗ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಈ ಟಿಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೆನ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಈ ಪೆನ್ ಇದು ಟಿಪ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ, ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಆ ಉದ್ದೇಶಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವೇನು ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್, ನಾವೇನು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಜಾಮೆಟ್ರಿ, ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ಜೆಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮೂರು ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್. बट इलू ना हाई स्कूल लेवल आगेबू कल अदू टू डायमेंशनल टू डायमेंशनल या करती है ओनली एरडे एक्सिस कन्सिडर्ता एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस सो इलू कल टू डायमेंशनल सो एक्सापल यू एक्सापल ना बोर्डल ऐने बरती दट इस आल एक्सापल फॉर् द टू डायमेंशनल बिकॉज इलोन पॉइंट बरदे अंतिको अथवा इलोन पॉइंट 1.1 पॉइंट बरदेनो एक्स एक्सिस डिस्टेंस ऐते वाई एक्सिस डिस्टेंस नमक गोता सो बोर्ड बोर्ड इज अ परफेक्ट एक्सापल फॉर द टू डायमेंशनल याक एक्स एक्सिस वाई एक्स एक्स एर एक्स एक्सिस वाई एक्सिस आमले बरती बरत पेन पेन सॉरी बुक आगेबू बुकली कूड़ा दट इस आलो एक्सापल फॉर् द एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस अली कूड़ा एक्स एक्सिस वाई एक्सिस एर एक्सिस सो अलगी ना पॉइंट बरीबू पॉइंट लोकेशन को बट नमें सपोज स्पेस अरे स्पेस इलो पॉइंट पॉइंट नन डिस्टेंस बे ई मीन अब पोजिशन बेंत आवे मिनिमम नमें डिस्टेंस डिस्टेंस टॉप फ्रॉम दैट वॉल फ्रॉम दैट वॉल इष्ट डिस्टेंस गोत्तादरे पॉइंट एल्लैते अन्नोदन्न ईजी एक्सप्लेन माडबहुदु अदक्कोस्कर नावेनु स्टडी माड्तीवि थ्री डैमेंशनल अन्न स्टडी माड्तीवि क्लियर सो दिस इज आल अबाउट अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट टू डैमेंशनल बट नाउ आल्सो आई एक्सप्लेन व्हाई शुड वी स्टडी द थ्री डैमेंशनल ज्योमेट्री एंड ऑल क्लियर सो इन दिस टॉपिक माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ई टॉपिकली स्पेस अल्ली एरडु पॉइंट इद्दरे हाउ टू कैलकुलेट डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम and also that is the nothing but section formula distance formula that we are going to discuss in this topic in detail clear and also see my dear students xy plane two dimensional now discuss madidvi first quadrant alli plus plus irutade second quadrant alli negative positive third quadrant alli negative negative fourth quadrant alli plus positive eradu lines anna perpendicular aga intersect aadre four part aga divide aagutade but three dimensional now en consider martteve ant helidre we will consider in three dimensional geometry we will consider three planes ana tagoltave so a plane is nothing but plane andre neve en assume madkore one paper anta ankor one paper ana one plane anta helu tagolabodu so mooru plane ana if we will consider three planes 1 2 3 like this we will consider the three planes my dear students say here it is you can take this as x axis y axis and z axis another one I am taking here it is so x dash o x y y dash z here it is z dash so my dear students here in three dimensional already I told you that we required three axis we should require it means we will take three planes we are taking so if three planes are if I consider three planes if they are perpendicular to each other then that will be like this x axis y axis z axis actually x axis and y axis we can visible we can imagine but z axis means that is another one plane actually that should be go inside the this board but we should consider here it is z axis I am taking here it is so please remember this is 3D imagination is very very important I'll show you one structure so that you can easily understand so here it is just as of now just understand we have the three axes these three axes are perpendicular to each other this is axis is nothing but we are considering the plane so just wait a minute I'll show you the one structure yes my dear students if you consider three planes so we will consider here it is three planes we are considering plane means what plane andre eno yavade ondu new paper anna tagondre adu example for the plane agirutade xy plane clear so illi nodi we will considering the three planes that is here it is this is x here it is consider this as one here it is first imagine how many planes are there this is one plane middle and here it is another one plane this is another one plane and this is another one plane clear so three planes are there please imagine imagination is very very important visualize the concept see here it is this is one plane my dear students so this is one plane clear and this is another one plane in the middle have you seen so this is another one plane and here this is also another one plane So like this, plain means what I told you. So just take, assume one paper of your book or like that. See, this is one plane, this is middle another one plane, and here it is another one plane. One plane, two plane, three plane. So like this we will consider. If we consider three planes, that is x-axis, that we can call, here it is, if I consider three planes perpendicular to each, three planes are perpendicular to each other and they are intersecting at a origin, then they will frame, the structure will be looks like rectangular. Is it looks like rectangle, my dear students? Please observe here this. Is it a rectangular shape is there? Clear? So see here this, is it like this? Rectangular shape is there. So therefore, if you consider the three planes, then that the three planes are perpendicular to each other, they all intersecting origin, here it is, at a point O, then that will looks, the entire structure will looks like rectangular in shape. And now this parts, here it is, here in this two dimensional, 1 2 3 4, four parts are there. Like that, if two lines are intersecting, then the entire two dimensional space, that is xy plane, dividing into four parts. Like that, if we consider in 3D, this is all about 3D, my dear students. In three dimensional geometry, if I consider in three dimensional geometry, if I consider the three planes, if three planes are perpendicular to each other, then they are also divided into eight parts. That parts we can call it as octants. So please remember, my dear students, that we can call it as octants. So please observe, here it is. Will you have you observing here it is? See, here it is, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4, like that, back side also, beside also, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So will you observe, my dear students? Octants means eight parts. 1 2 3 4, here it is, above 4, below 4, or else like this, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. So this is the, if, so therefore remember, if we have the three planes intersecting, the three planes perpendicular to each other, they are intersecting at a point O, means they divided into eight parts. These eight parts we can call it as octants. Am I clear? So how will be the points in me? It means in the first quadrant, first octant, how will be the points? Second octant, how will be the points? That we are going to observe. And please remember, my dear students, this X, here it is, if I consider Y, O, Z, if I consider means X, here it is, this Y, O, Z, if I consider means Y, O, Z, this is, we can call it as a YZ plane. We can consider it as YZ plane. If I take Z, O, Z, if I consider Z, O, Z means this is nothing but Z dash Z plane, we can take, my distance. Clear? Or else X dash O, Y means what should I consider? I should take this or leave this origin, only take, we can consider it as X dash Y plane, we can consider. Clear? And please remember, my dear students, in the two dimensional, already I told you that here always on the X axis the point will be X comma 0, it means Y value will be 0. Like that, in the Y axis always point is, here it is 0 comma Y. Clear? That already we learned. Here it is, X axis alli yavaglu point yav formula irutate, X comma 0. X comma 0 means illi tandra 2 comma 0, illi idre 1 comma 0, ee riti irutade X axis alli. Ade Y axis alli idre point yav riti irutade, Y axis alli yavaglu X value 0 irutade, 0 comma Y, athava 0 comma illi point idre 0 comma 2, 0 comma 1. Always on the Y axis X value is 0, always on the X axis Y value is 0, X comma 0 formula irutade. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ದ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ 0 0. ಎಮ್ ಐ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮೈ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್? ಆನ್ ದ ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ದ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್, ಹೌ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೈ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್? 0, ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೈ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, y 0. And on the z axis, how will be the coordinates? How will be the points, my dear students? On the z axis, 0, 0, z. So generally we will denote the coordinates on the xy as x, y, z. If I consider the point on the x-axis, means generally how will be the point on the x-axis coordinate x, 0, 0. Y-axis 0, y, 0. Z-axis 0, 0, z. Yav axis idu now coordinate na barita irutevi. Uludella axis 0 irutade. Yav present irutate adu matra that is also that will be present. Here it is. It means z-axis barita idre 0, 0, z. Y-axis barita idre 0, y, 0. X-axis barita idre x, 0, 0. Generally point anna three dimensional geometry generally point anna yavarthi denote martheve anta helidre suppose illi on point idre x, y, z. Clear? So that already we discussed in the two dimensional. Two dimensional kuda x axis alli idre x present irthati uladu y value 0 irthati. Y axis alli y present irthati x 0 irthati. Ade reethi three dimensionally x axis yavadandre x, 0, 0. The coordinates of y axis are 0, y, 0. The coordinates of z axis are 0, 0, z. Generally, three dimensionally point yavarthi irthati anta helidre x, y, z. This is, please remember this one. Sometimes they may ask 1 mark or else that is useful to answer the questions of the 2 mark or 5 mark questions. Actually, for this topic, we have 5 marks. Clear? So these are the coordinates, my dear students. Clear? And the origin point. So origin and ayavarthi paritevi. Origin point is nothing but 0, 0, 0. This is nothing but the origin. Clear? And please remember the xy plane is divided into 8 parts. But now then 8 parts anta heladilla 8 parts badlu now in anta heltavi octants. So first octant, second octant, third octant, fourth octant, fifth octant, sixth octant, seventh octant, eighth octant. Totally we have the 8 octants we have. I hope you understood. Still if you have any doubts you can comment me. Please pause the video to note it down. Next, I'll explain how will be the points. I mean, how will be here, how we discussed in the first quadrant, positive, positive, in the second quadrant, negative, positive, like that. How will be in the octants, that I'm going to discuss. Please pause the video. Next, I'll write the octants. How will be the points? Please pause the video to note it down. Yes. Now consider, my dear students, how will be the octants that already I told you, wrote signs of coordinates of a point in various octants. In different octants, how will be the points? So here I wrote octants, first octant, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. And here it is coordinate, what will be x, y, z, whether x is positive, y is positive or not, z is positive or not, that we are going to write this one, my dear students. So please remember, sometimes in competitive examinations for 1 mark, they will give you the question like, write the coordinates of the 7th octant, write the coordinates of the 3rd octant, like that they are going, they may ask. So for that reason, my dear students, remember this one, how I am writing this one, that I explained here. So first of all, consider, please remember, here it is, this is x-axis. I hope you are understanding. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. This one is y-axis and this one is towards you is z-axis. So please remember, this is x-axis, this is y-axis and this one is z-axis. And this one is positive x-axis, negative x-axis. Positive y-axis, positive y-axis, negative y-axis. Positive z-axis, negative z-axis. I'll repeat once again, this one is x-axis, positive x-axis, and here it is negative x-axis, positive y-axis, negative y-axis, positive z-axis, negative z-axis. Clear? So let us take this one as first octant. So in the first octant, what in the first octant, this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that we are dividing. This, consider this as first octant, second octant, third octant, fourth octant, fifth octant, sixth, seventh, eighth. Clear? In the first octant, how will be the points? In the first octant here, my dear students, observe here. In the first octant, here it is x is. What about x? X is positive. X is positive and Y is also positive, my dear students. And what about Z1? Z is also positive. This is all about first quadrant. X is positive, Y is positive, and Z is also positive. Next, in the second quadrant, X is negative, and Y is positive, and Z is also positive. This is in the second quadrant. In the third quadrant, my dear students, consider this as the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, you can imagine here it is. This is negative, negative x-axis, and here it is in the third quadrant. Even here it is, this one is y-axis, negative y-axis. Here it is, y-axis is negative, and this one is z-axis is positive. This is third quadrant. And next, shift here, I mean consider here in the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, x is positive and Y is, here it is, negative. This is origin, my dear students. Remember, this one is origin. So below this one means this is negative y-axis in the fourth quadrant. Here it is, and this is towards you. This is z-axis, positive z-axis. This is all about fourth quadrant. Next, come to the fifth quadrant, means beside of this one. Here it is fifth quadrant. Please see, it is here, it is fifth quadrant. So in the fifth quadrant, what happens? In the fifth quadrant, X is positive and Y is also positive, and Z means here towards me, this one is negative. This is fifth quadrant. In the sixth quadrant, my dear student, in the sixth quadrant means here X is negative, here it is, and Y is positive, and towards me, z-axis, that is nothing but negative. Clear? And next, seventh means here it is, somewhere here. So seventh means, please remember, here it is, seventh means imagination is very, very important. Here it is, X is negative, Y is also, means below this origin, negative, and towards me, z-axis, that is also negative. This is seventh. And next one is eighth, my dear students, last one. In the eighth also, X is positive, Y is negative, and towards me, Z is negative. Like this, we can write this table, my dear students. So please remember, so this table is very, very important. So how will be the signs, that is X coordinate, Y coordinate, and Z coordinate, in the first octant, second octant, third octant, fourth octant, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. Like this, you should remember, my dear students. I hope you understood. Still, if you have any doubts, you can comment me. I'll reply for that one. And observe, my dear students, here I'm talking only about the z-axis. Observe, here it is, the z-axis will be positive. The z-axis is positive in first 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. In first 1, 2, 3, 4, first 4 octants, the Z is, I am talking only about the Z. Please remember, Z is positive in the first 2, see, the fourth quadrant, first 4. And next, in the second, here it is, in the second part, means 5, 6, 7, 8. Here, 5, 6, 7, 8, the Z will be, Z is negative, and Z is positive in the first 4 octants. And in the remaining 4 octants, Z is negative. This is small hint, and you should remember remaining all, my dear students. I hope you understood. Still, if you have any doubts, you can comment me. And here it is, visualization is very, very important. So please remember this table, sometimes for 1 mark or 2, 1 mark. Sometimes in competitive exams, they may ask. The question will be like this. Write the coordinate of the 6th octant or 4th octant. Like that, they may ask, my dear students. I hope you understood. And please, another one thing, note here it is, or remember, what is that one? The coordinates, the generally the coordinates or in the three dimensional are x, y, z. And the coordinates of x axis are x, 0, 0. The coordinates of the y axis are 0, y, 0. The coordinates of the z axis are 0, 0, z. Like this will be there. And origin is, in the case of three-dimensional geometry, the origin is 0, 0, 0. Clear? And x, o, y, here it is. This y-axis we can call it as y, o, y dash. This we can consider it as the y, y dash plane, we can call. and here it is z dash o z, we can call it as z dash z plane, like that we can call. And x dash o x can be called, we can call it as only x dash x plane, or we like that we can call, my dear students. So here I shown the axis, but actually it is not axis, here we are considering the planes. Clear? So now in the next class we are going to discuss the distance between two points, that all we are discuss in the next video. I hope you understood. Still, if you have any doubts, please comment me, I'll reply for that. Please pause the video to note it down. Thank you.